I've always had it ever since I was a child. I was 4 years old, and I used to lie in bed and see all these people walk towards me. I used to love it because I thought, that's clever, they walk through the wall and they will give me messages and tell me things, and I didn't understand what they were talking about. And they just kept saying to me, you're a special little girl. But, you know, children see people or imaginary friends. These weren't imaginary, you know. I knew that they weren't, but they would tell me things, help me through my life, but I kept it a secret. So I didn't come out the spiritual closet for about 25 years.
For the whole of my life, I was raised in a nursing home and I had visitors all the time to the nursing home. And I thought they were alive till my grandmother said to me one day when I was a teenager and said, you know all those people that used to come to you as a child? And I'd say, yes. She said, they were deceased. And I went, oh, I thought they were real.
I basically have been able to see spirit people since I was a child. So I've always believed that you have to do what you love in the world and everything will fall into place therefore after.
You know, I had very normal jobs, you know. I worked in offices and things like that. But I always knew, because there was a calling, I can't explain it. You know, having something or an ability and yet you're not working on it, you just feel like your life isn't completed. And that's what I've come to complete my life, basically, and this is what I do.
I wasn't satisfied with my normal life. Normal life being I was a chef by trade, and I decided just to back myself and, you know, get the buzz of helping people, because it's a bit of an addiction. The pleasure I get from doing the work is, you know, for me it's amazing and I enjoy it. It's always a, I guess, a privilege, if you like, and an honour to help people who have lost someone that they love, and that excites me, and so that's what keeps me inspired and keeps me going.
But I remember it. I remember the moment that I said to Spirit, what am I supposed to be doing in my life? And they said, what you're doing, this is it. You got no choice. You made your choice before you came to Earth. I went, oh, okay. So that was it.
I think the most important thing, though, is that for me to be able to have found my way, I just needed to be true to myself as a person and not pretend to be something that I wasn't. So this is the way I am.